Are you interested in making this type of 3D animated video? Then this video is for you. In this video, I'm going to take you through step-by-step process on how to create this 3D animated video without spending lots of money. We'll start from the scripting to the final editing. So if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel for more interesting video like this. Okay, let's dive in. The first thing we are going to start with is our script, and we'll be using ChatGPT for that. I already have an idea of what I want. So here I wrote that, create a structured scene outline for an animated short video based on the story idea. Each scene should be listed with a short description of what happens. Keep it simple and concise. So you can see I just listed out my scene, the first one. So if you have an idea in mind, you don't want ChatGPT to give you an idea, you can use this prompt that I just used now. Just write your scene. Here I wrote out 11 scenes. Then I said, create a structured scene outline for an animated short video for me. And immediately I clicked on create. ChatGPT now created a very good, concise, short scene for me. You can see my scene here. Then after creating this my scene, I'm going to go ahead to generate a consistent character. The beauty of 3D animated video is for you to be able to generate consistent character throughout your video. So I'm going to go ahead to prompt ChatGPT to help me and write out a consistent character for each scene. So here, and I told ChatGPT, for this video, write out the character to generate a consistent character throughout the scenes. So you can see what ChatGPT gave to me, the main character, Handsome Cat. So you can see everything, both the species, the fur color, the eye color, the fur texture, but everything here is too much. It is too big for me to use it and generate a consistent character for the scenes. So what I now did is that, and now further on, I told ChatGPT to give me a prompt to generate this character consistently across the scenes. So you can see ChatGPT now gave me something that is very good to work with. So you can see my first character, the supporting character prompt, and also the organizers and everything. So after I must have generated this consistent character prompt, I will go ahead to generate my video prompt. So I will go ahead and prompt ChatGPT to write out these video scenes and include the image prompt. I said ChatGPT to present it in a tabular format. So I said, first of all, present it in a tabular format, scene one, image prompt, and the third one, the video prompt. And here is my structured scene breakdown in a tabular format. You can see my structure. So I'm going to copy this, and the next thing I'm going to do is to generate my images for this video. And to generate my images for this video, I'll be using Canva AI. So head over to Canva. In the home page there, you will see Canva AI. You can see the Canva AI. Click on it. Then once you click on it, you will see this prompt box there. This prompt box, this is where we'll be pasting our prompts in order to generate our images. So in this prompt box, I'm going to go ahead to click on create an image. You see this create an image, click on it. Then once you click on this create an image, you go over to the prompt box and start pasting in your prompt. So I'll go over to the prompt box and paste my prompt. Within a second, Canva is going to generate my images for me. And guess what? These images are high quality images. You can see my image. I'll go ahead and generate all my images for this video. So I'm done generating my images with Canva. And the next thing I'm going to do is to animate this my image. I'm going to show you two AI tools which you can use to animate your images for free. I'll be showing you how to use Clink AI and also Pizverse AI to animate your images. The first AI tool we'll be using is Clink AI. Go over to clinkai.com. Then this is the interface. You go over to video. You will see the AI generation and you see the image and video. Click on the video since we want to turn our image to video. Then you will see the prompt box there first. Then after the prompt box, you will see DeepSeek and everything. So the first thing we are going to do is to upload our image. So I'm going to click on this click/drop/paste. So I'll click on it. Then it will direct me to my gallery where I will select my image here. So I'm going to select this image here. Then once it's uploaded, I'll come over to this prompt box. So this Clink AI has DeepSeek AI, which you can use to write your video prompt. So if you click on this DeepSeek is going to analyze your image. Once it's done analyzing your image, it will give you a good video prompt based on that your image. So here is a video prompt that DeepSeek generated for me based on my image. You can see the cartoon cat went down, the vibrant colorful house. And if you want to use this video prompt, you just click on use prompt. You can see my prompt in my prompt box here. The cartoon cat sprints down the vibrant streets, colorful houses. So it's okay. So I will go ahead and click on generate, and it's going to take me 20 credits for me to turn this image to video. So I click on generate for Clink AI to turn my image to video. And it's going to take a few minutes to generate our video. So here is our video. It comes with a free sound. So I'm going to show you the next free AI tool which you can use to convert your images to video, and this is Pizverse. Pizverse is very easy to use, and Pizverse gives us barely 60 credits. And to turn your images to video is very simple. All you have to do, go down to this prompt box there. You will see this image icon. Click on it to import your image. So I'm going to click on this image here. I'll click on it. Then after it must have uploaded, I'll go over to the prompt box, the text part. Describe your object. So I'm going to type in a simple prompt. So I'm not going to type in or paste in the prompt ChatGPT gave to us. It's very complex for Pizverse. I'm just going to type in walking, singing, dance. Just a simple prompt for Pizverse so that it will give you a good output. So once I'm done, I'm going to click on generate. So it's going to take us few seconds, unlike Clink AI that takes minutes to generate video. So it's going to take us few seconds to generate our video. So here is my video. You can see it very easy. Please, if you are using Pizverse, make sure that you use a simple video prompt. Don't use a complex one. Okay, now we are done generating our videos. So the next thing I'm going to do is to edit. I'm going to bring in our videos, our video clips, and editing it using CapCut. So I've brought in my video clips scene by scene. You can see them. So if you are trying to make this video, you have to first of all bring in your video clips. And if you notice something, Clink AI videos have high quality videos, whereas Pizverse doesn't have high quality video. The next thing I'm going to do is that I'm going to increase the quality of this video. So I have to click on it and go over to adjust, then go over to sharpen and increase it to 100%. So you can watch it, you can see the difference. So I'll go over to all the videos created by Pizverse and do the same thing. Just click on it, go over to adjust, then when you're in adjust and click on sharpen, increase the sharpen percentage to 100. So you can see the difference. After doing this, the next thing I'm going to do is to add sound effects. To add my sound effect, I'll go over to audio, click on it and go over to the sound FX. I'm going to be searching the sound effect that is relevant to my video. So I'll type in running footsteps. So since my character is running, I want a running footsteps. So I'm going to listen to this sound effect. The one that matches or suits my video, I'll click on the plus icon. So I'm going to stretch it to my clip. So I'll go ahead and add other relevant sound effects to my video clips. So I'm done adding my sound effect to my video. The next thing I'm going to do is to add audio. So I wanted this meow 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 song that is running on YouTube. So all I did is that I went to YouTube and I screen recorded the video. And I'm going to go over to my overlay to add this video that I screen recorded to my video here. So I'm going to extract the audio. I'll click on the video and I'll go over to extract audio. So I'll click on this extract audio and I'm going to extract the song and I'll delete the overlay, the video there. So this is how you can be able to use all this sound from YouTube. So I'm done extracting my audio and adding audios to my video. I've also added the sound effects and also enhanced our video. So the next thing I'm going to do is to export this video. So let me export it and show you the final result. So here is my final video. You can see how beautiful it is with the sound effect and also the audio. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel for more beautiful videos like this. See you next time.